In the last video, we built a gated and door latch as a memory unit. Depends on how we connect the transistors, there are 4 different logic gates. Not surprisingly, there are various ways to build memory using different gates. For simplicity, let's use logic gate symbols to represent the circuit. Besides the AND OR latch, there are NAND latch, NOR latch. They are very similar. In this video, we are going to see how to pick each component. You will understand why they work. Regardless of the exact model, there are 2 control gates connected to 2 output gates crisscrossed with each other. Both control gates are connected to control signal directly and connected to inputs either directly or indirectly. So I'm using dashed lines to imply the flexibilities. We need to choose the control gate so that input can always pass and stay. When the control is on, input is able to pass. And NAND should be considered, because when we turn on control to pass data, when transistor is conducting, their outputs depend on the other input. As input changes, so would output, allowing different inputs to reach output gates. Unlike OR NOR, the high control signal will fix the outputs. No matter how the other input changes now, output stays the same, preventing passing different inputs. Depends on the control gates chosen, the middle inputs could be either the same or different from the original input. So I'm using dashed arrows here. When control is off, control gates will cut off input changes from affecting output gates. Because AND NAND gates will output constant voltages when one transistor is turned off, a low for AND and a high for NAND. No matter how input changes, output would be the same. Now the job is to choose output gates so that input can always pass and stay. Since there are only 2 types of inputs, we only have 2 cases to worry about. 4 gate choices for each of the output gates, leading to 16 combos. So I'm going to find out which pairs work first. I'm putting all the cases here because gate choices depend on the signals needed in these cases. Our goal is to resolve these unknown signals so that gate choices will be clear. For any output gate chosen, there is always a signal having no issues passing. I call it determining input. The other one would be the non-determining input. Let me explain more detail. For AND NAND, the output is controlled by only one route. So one low voltage is enough to shut down the only route, determining the output. A low for AND and a high for NAND. So low is the determining input for AND NAND. For simplicity, I'm using gate symbols. For OR NOR, output is controlled by either of the 2 routes. As long as you turn on one route, output will be determined. Again, the difference is in the output, high for OR, low for NOR. So high is the determining input for them. Conversely, the opposite signal, non-determining input, has issues passing. To pass a high through AND NAND, you need both high. To pass a low through OR NOR, you need both low. I'm using green for determining input and red for non-determining one. So to pass this non-determining input, we need to have a second non-determining one for help, coming from this lower gate. To get it to provide an output, we need a determining input from the lower control gate. But for its output to be the one required, we need to choose a lower gate that can use its determining input to push out a non-determining one for the upper gate. Out of the 16 possibilities for the output pairs, if we map out the outputs from the lower gates under the determining inputs, there are 8 pairs where the lower gate is actually feeding a determining input to the upper gate, causing the non-determining signal unable to pass. If we connect the control gate properly to the input, it can provide the determining signal needed. So the remaining 8 pairs will ensure input is able to pass. But once the input connection is made, it means that when passing the opposite signal, the lower gate will see its non-determining input. So let's put it down here. Once input passes, output is fed back to the lower gate to help it stay. Let's see how. Output can stay if we can maintain the input coming from the control gate and the lower gate. But unfortunately, once turned off, control gate can only provide one type of input, either determining or non-determining. So two cases are requiring conflicting inputs from the upper control gate. We have to pick one. The first case can afford to have a non-determining input if it has a backup from the lower gate. So these upper control gate needs to provide a non-determining input when control is off. The problem now is how to get a lower gate to provide the backup. We already choose the lower gate to use this determining input to produce a non-determining one for the upper gate. Here we are requiring an opposite output from the lower gate. So we have to use two non-determining inputs. The upper one comes from the upper gate's output when passing input, so that the lower gate can produce the backup needed. Now we are requiring the upper gate to use its determining input to produce a non-determining one for the lower gate. Four pairs failed this, leaving us four pairs. But once they are chosen, it means the second case will see a determining input from the upper gate. It seems redundant for now, because you only need one determining input to either pass or hold the output. But the first case isn't done yet. To make the first case stay, the final requirement is a non-determining input from the lower control gate. So these lower control gate also needs to provide a non-determining input when control is off. Meaning that in the second case, the lower gate will see a signal change from determining to the non-determining. But it doesn't matter, because the redundant will work as a backup now. So these four pairs will make sure input can pass and stay. The remaining job is to pick control gates. Pick the one that can provide the non-determining signal to the output gate when control is off. AND gate will provide a low voltage under lock mode, working for parallel gates. NAND will output a constant high, working for serial gates. I'm coloring those pairs so that you know who works with whom. Now we're ready to finish the design. Since we've gone through AND OR latch before, we're focusing on NAND NOR. First step, pick control gates. NAND for NAND. AND for NOR. Then connect input to the control gates, so that when control is on, two opposite inputs reach output gates. Input changes, they should alternate. We can connect upper NAND gate to input directly. It will pass input inverted. Connect it to the lower gate. It will invert it back. So they must be opposite. AND gate will pass input unchanged, but NOR will invert it. So to have the correct output, we can pass an inverted input to the upper gate. Connect input directly to the lower gate. These two must be opposite all the time. Since they are opposite, one must be the determining and the other the non-determining. The determining side will use its output to help the other side pass. In turn, the non-determining side will use its output to help the determining side to stay by producing the backup. So that when control is off, input is cut off. The control gate ensures that only one side will switch. But it doesn't matter because of the backup.